to gather together to worship King Jesus first and foremost. Amen. That's what the Christmas season is all about. It's not about buying gifts. It's not about the big man in the red suit. It is all about the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And that's what this play is all about. So I welcome you here to Griffin Baptist Church. My name is Mike. I'm the pastor here. And once again, welcome. We're glad that you have come this evening. To open up tonight, I would like to read some scripture to you. It comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 6 and 7. Here's what the word of the Lord says. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government of peace, there will be no end on the throne of David, and over his kingdom to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Would you join me in prayer? Father, again, we are thankful to gather this Lord's Day in this room to first and foremost to worship you. Father, we are thankful for this day that we have, that we can come together, Father, that we were able this morning to hear your word proclaimed, that we were able to sing hymns and just give of ourselves to you. And Father, tonight as we regather for this Lord's Day service, Father, I pray that, Father, that you are lifted up and exalted above all else. Father, as we observe this Christmas program, I, Father, pray that you would bless each person that is in it, give them boldness, give them confidence, and the ease and the nerve that they may have. Father, we thank you for this precious time we have together. We love you and we praise you, and we pray this in the mighty name of Jesus our Lord, and all God's people say,
Amen.
Would you all stand, take a hymn book out of the pew in front of you, and turn to page 87. Let's sing Joy to the World.
Amen.
most wonderful time of the year. The sights and sounds of Christmas are everywhere. Most of us have already, or will soon be, putting up a tree. Some will decorate throughout the house. Others will string lights on the outdoor shrubs, or maybe set on a manger scene. Then there are those who fill up their wands with all sizes and shapes of objects. And when lit up, can be seen by those on the International Space Station. As we travel through our Christmas scenes, let's see where you find yourself, what place Jesus takes in your celebrations, and how you would answer the question, what does Christmas mean to me? Christmas, It's a Wonderful Life, or Home Alone. This holiday season, many will watch all 15 new Hallmark Christmas movies. And let's be honest, they all in the same way. One of our favorite Christmas movies is Elf. According to Buddy the Elf, the four main food groups are candy, candy canes, candy corn, and syrups. Maybe one of my family traditions includes attending or participating in the local Christmas parade. Who doesn't love listening to those jolly Christmas tunes, seeing all the little dancers dressed up as elves, or a Christmas package? Looking to see what costumes will be used to embarrass the neighborhood dogs, and waiting to see who has the most awesome antique vehicle registered, all the while waiting for Santa and the candy from the sheriff.
I'm so excited about the Christmas parade. Oh, this is going to be fun.
This will be a great time.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Some
gingers!
Some
gingers!
To it. Even Christians can lose their joy and lose their way. The storms of life can take their toll on all of us. Some of you may be sitting here right now, and you feel nothing. No emotion, no peace, no hope. Life has disappointed you, but unfair for no real reason. Maybe you're discouraged, tired, beaten down by struggles and unanswered questions. You no longer believe God cares. No longer do you believe in prayer, and maybe you've given up on Jesus. But you know what? He hasn't given up on you. Not a single day, not a single hour has he ever stopped loving you, and he never will. Even if you can't hear his voice or see his hand, he's still standing with his arms wide open, reaching, calling, longing to restore your joy, to make all things new.
All is crying everywhere.
became engaged to Joseph, an apprentice carpenter in the village of Nazareth. It was customary for the bride to remain in her father's home until the bridegroom came for her. It was during this time that the angel, Gabriel, appeared to her with a message. Fear not, for behold, thou hast found favor with God, and he for whom thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and shall bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. As Mary thought on these things which the angel had told her, she certainly must have been filled with wonder to think that God has passed by the rich and mighty to allow her, in her humble state, to usher in this greatest of all events.
Thank you.
Robe of majesty to be clothed in swaddling clothes. It's about the one who can hold the universe in the palm of his hand, but gave that up to be conceived in the womb of a teenage girl. It's about the sinless, perfect Son of God who came to die for sinners like me. Sinners like me. So let's not forget who started Christmas, or why he started it. The busy season, remember him no matter what you're doing. Whether it's wrapping a gift or cooking a meal, think about him at your children's programs or while shopping in the mall. At the end of the day, this isn't about putting Jesus first, because he put his life on the line for us. He humbled himself and became a man. A man who lived and died the once and for all death for our sins. The salvation of our lives is more important than the saving of his life.
Thank you.
how lonely I feel this Christmas. I want to unwrap the gift of your presence each day. Help me see you. Hear your voice speak to my heart. And pay attention when you lead me with your peace and perspective. I see your purpose in all of my plans. In Jesus' name, amen. We now lift our hearts in worship and celebrate the birth of the one who came the first Christmas, one who continues to bring joy to our world.
Guys, another round of applause. proud of them, and as you all know, the yuck is going around like something fierce right now, so for those who were singing tonight, I know a couple of them were a little nervous, so praise the Lord, we got through, right, Miss Mary? All right, well, I also want to thank Miss Mary and Miss Diana. They were the ones that put all of this together, so everything you see. And that's to redeem a people to himself. It is you and me that have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. And there's this awesome scene in Revelation chapter 7 where the Apostle John is gazing up into heaven. And he essentially sees what I call the Great Commission consummated. People of every tribe, nation, and tongue worshiping the King. And all of that was possible. All of that was set in motion on that very first Christmas morning when Jesus was laying in that manger. And I would like to close with that passage. It comes from Revelation chapter 7, verses 9 and following. It says, "After this I looked, and behold, a great multitude that no one could number, from every nation, from all tribes and people and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, 'Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb.' And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, 'Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forevermore. Amen. Join in prayer. Father, we thank you so much for this evening that we were able to gather together in this place, Father, to celebrate what Jesus set in motion that very first Christmas morning. We thank you, Lord, for your love, your grace, your mercy, that love that was supremely manifested to us in the Word that was made flesh, King Jesus. Thank you for this holiday season. I thank you for each person that is here tonight, Father. And as we go our separate ways, I pray that, Father, you guide and protect us and bring us back at the appointed time. Father, we love you and we thank you for all that you do. And we give you the praise, the glory, and honor. In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Amen. Amen.